Hi, my name is Flo, and in this video I want to talk to you about the newspaper report from Japan that Tesla's Hardware 3 electronics is 6 years ahead of Toyota and VW, and that they, quote, cannot do it. But first I want to ask you to subscribe to my channel and also hit the notification bell. It is much appreciated and it helps the channel a lot. Let's start. Some days ago, the Japanese financial newspaper Nikkei published a report about a teardown of a Model 3 which they performed. This is not the first reported teardown of a Model 3. The engineering research and consulting firm Munro & Associates and, according to German newspapers, German car manufacturer did analyze the Model 3 too. In all these reports, especially the electronics have been praised. For example, engineers of a German car manufacturer said the electronics are compact, expandable, fully integrated, modular, easily accessible, well protected, inexpensive, and amazingly clever in many details. Nikkei was the first organization who published the results of a teardown of a Model 3 with Tesla's newest Hardware 3 electronics, introduced in 2019. And the Hardware 3 electronics was what shocked Nikkei and an engineer of an unnamed major Japanese car manufacturer. It is so advanced, the unnamed Japanese car manufacturer could not do it, said the engineer. Industry insiders said to Nikkei that they expect major car manufacturer to be on the same technological level in 2025, which translates to the 6-year advantage mentioned in the report. But why is Tesla 6 years ahead of the competition in terms of electronic? Did Tesla find an alien spacecraft and reverse engineered it? No, in its core, it's two things. Firstly, Tesla started on a clean sheet of paper and did not outsource the most valuable technologies of their cars, and the Hardware 3 is part of this. Hardware 3 was developed completely in-house by Tesla, designed specifically to their needs. And the head of Tesla's autopilot hardware department is Pete Bannon, who, for example, worked at Apple and Intel before, in both cases in the area of chip design. Pete Bannon was allowed to create a team at Tesla specifically for the task of developing Hardware 3. Also, Elon Musk allowed him to go forward with a custom design despite being the more expensive solution. This shows, as examples, the mindset of Tesla with their electronics has more the approach of companies like, for example, Apple, Samsung or AMD. It shows a competitive mindset going for fast development cycles and cutting-edge technological solutions. So it can be said that Tesla's hardware is not from the future, but it shows what's technologically possible today if you allow your engineers to do their best. Secondly, we are back at the problems of the established car manufacturer. They rely heavily on their suppliers, and the suppliers rely heavily on them. And a Japanese engineer mentions that to Nikkei. It isn't that they could not build electronics on a comparable level. It is that they would more or less kill the suppliers if they choose to replace dozens of electronic control units, or ECUs as they are also called, from dozens of suppliers with one fully integrated ECU. Suddenly, thousands of employees of suppliers like, for example, Bosch, Autoliv or Denso would lose their jobs. The partnership with the suppliers has been cultivated over decades and cannot be stopped immediately, he said. Also, car manufacturer and its suppliers are very conservative. The main idea is proven designs should not be changed. The reasons are, for example, the reliability of older designs and the lower costs of older designs. Also, new designs have the risk of every new technology. Nobody knows what will happen in the future. Will it be reliable? Will there be a bug? Will there be a major problem and we would have to do a recall? Also, car manufacturers have the mindset of planning years ahead. They today know very exactly which ECU will be in the upcoming new cars and they will keep it that way. You can almost say they don't like surprises. They never would go the way of Tesla, offering Model S, X and 3 and start developing costly new hardware for these cars whilst they are on sale. I think if you want to convince the management to massively improve a car that is on sale right now, you're going to have to try real hard. If it is not pressure from the government, like CO2 regulations, that you need to counter with new engines, no big and especially costly improvements will happen. So, not choosing or offering a fully integrated ECU is to an extent understandable, but it is also not understandable. For a car manufacturer, not choosing a fully integrated ECU leads in the long run to a major technological disadvantage. He should let go the supplier if he can supply him with state-of-the-art technology. He firstly needs to secure its own survival, even if it means developing its own ECU designs. For the suppliers, not offering a fully integrated ECU is a risk of losing the ECU departments in the long run. They also should start to offer new ECU designs to secure their survival. If the supplier is a small supplier who really just lives from ECUs, he needs to transition even faster. Right now, both parties did choose the worst way of dealing with the situation. Keep doing what you are doing. But especially for the suppliers, it is extremely dangerous to think that they can live from old tech because they can rely on some kind of mercy of the car manufacturer to buy their old ECUs. Surely, the transition from many dedicated ECUs to fully integrated ECUs leads to people losing their jobs. But the earlier you start the transition, the less it will hurt and less people are affected. Both parties do not seem to show interest in at least adapting to the new situation. No interest in preparing for the future. No interest in seeing Tesla as real competition. This is dangerous and leads to an advantage for Tesla. Tesla does not even have to fight hard with their electronics design. They are the only ones in this field. As there is no competition, they are automatically the best. So, in the end, and if Tesla fans see this video, please don't be angry. It isn't that Tesla is more advanced or more intelligent than the other car manufacturer. It is that Tesla is profiting from the wrong mindset of the established car manufacturers. When you see topics like this Hardware 3 news from Japan, in the end it leads always to the point where you can think the attitude of laziness, slowness and perhaps fear of change, as well as arrogance of the established car manufacturers, leads to situations like this. It weirdly makes the fight between Tesla and the other car manufacturers easier for Tesla than it normally should be. So, as a conclusion, Tesla is not 6 years ahead as most newspapers and websites wrote. No, more correctly, the competition is 6 years behind and actively enables Tesla's technological advantage. So that's it from me, and let me know what you think of this news report on the Hardware 3, and please like, share, subscribe and also hit the notification bell as more videos are coming soon.